Hi, everybody. I'm DJ Foster. Welcome to this week's installment of the Doug Woods Show, our weekly look at Grand Valley State softball with Laker head coach Doug Woods. Coach, thanks for joining me today.
Thank you.
Well, you closed out the regular season this past week. You went 2-4 in three league doubleheaders. So you end the regular season 37-12. That's your most wins since 2003. And you go 23-9 in GLIAC play. And the 23 GLIAC wins are the most you've ever had here. We'll start with Hillsdale. That was a rescheduled game from last week, it looks like. And then you played them on Thursday. You win game one 8-3. Katie Martin and Miranda Cleary both homer, as you've coined them, MC Hammer. And Brittany Taylor had two triples in that game. And then a little tough one in the nightcap. You went 6-3, but it goes nine innings. We just got that finish before it got a little too dark out. Katie Martin with a go-ahead single on a weird play that you can talk about. And then Tanya Calkins gave a little bit of insurance with a two-run hit. Hannah Santora got the win, giving up just one hit in four innings. Talk a little bit about the sweep over Hillsdale.
Yeah, those were two good wins. Annie Nicholson pitched well in the first game, and the bats were live, and we did well. Second game, they threw the same pitcher that beat us 1-0 at their place. So we struggled a little bit with her, and then went extra innings, and we hung in there. As you said, Hannah Santora came in, and Hannah basically shut them down for four innings on that. A little bit weird play with Katie's single. We had Brianna Taylor on first base, and Katie, with two outs, hits a single. That's a sort of a pop fly to right field, drops in, and Brianna was able to score from first base. That's pretty difficult to do, but I saw her coming towards third. She had a full head of steam, and there was no stopping her. Let her go, and she got in. So don't see that play happen too often, but looked good to me.
Sure, yeah, it counts any way you look at it. Well, you go to Saginaw this weekend, and you had a tough matchup with their ace pitcher, Jade Fulton, one of the top pitchers, obviously, in the conference and the region. You lose game one on Friday, 2-0, but Andrea Nicholson pitched very well for you. She, in six innings, she gave up two runs on six hits. And then game two, you lost 13-3. Emily Holt with a three-run homer in that game for your scoring. Talk a little about Friday's doubleheader.
Well, once again, Andy pitched well enough to win. We just didn't get any offensive support. Their pitcher, Jade Fulton, pitched very, very well. She's a very good pitcher. I'm hoping that was her best weekend of the year, but she did a nice job against us and really had us off stride the whole dang day.
On Saturday, she pitched both games again, which is kind of rare to see a pitcher pitch four times in one weekend, but you hung with them both games. You lost game one on Saturday 7-3, Brittany Taylor with a two-run double late in that game, and then 4-3 was the final in game two. Katie Martin hit a two-run homer, and Brianna hit a solo homer, Brianna Taylor, in the sixth inning to get you right back in the game. And then in the seventh, you had the bases loaded at the end of the game. You almost got, winning runs on third base. You almost got it in, but Fulton got out of it, and Saginaw got the wins. Talk a little bit about Saginaw.
Well, we were definitely at that time hoping to at least salvage one game out of this series. But I'll give credit to the players. We were down 4-0 fairly early in that game and hung in there. And then in the sixth, Nellie Casola was coming up and said, "Nellie, get on base for Katie, would you please?" And she did, and Katie hit a two-run homer, and then Brianna hit a shot. And we're 4-3, and even in that, we kept that inning going. We had a runner on third, and we struck out to end the inning. And then, as you said, the bottom of the seventh, I thought, dang, maybe we can get it going here. We had runners on, loaded them again, and did not get it done in the seventh. But at least we showed a little bit of fight and came back in that game.
Sure. Now, looking forward to this week, GLIAC tournament time. You go to Northwood for hopefully a few games, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. The weather obviously might play a little factor in that. But first game, the only game you know for sure you're playing, you'll play Wayne State on Friday at 10 a.m., and then it's a double elimination tournament, so it kind of goes from there to see where you'll play next. What are your thoughts going into this weekend with the tournament? Kind of give your mindset going in.
Well, first thing, hope we get to play it. Last year we got rained out. They're struggling with fields that aren't underwater up there, and I'm sure they'll come up with a good situation of where we're going to play in that area. But you look at the teams in 1-8, coaches always say, "Oh, everybody can beat anybody," but you can with our league this year, and it's been proven out during the regular season. So you better be on the top of your game this weekend, and hopefully we are.
Well, best of luck in the tournament this weekend. Hope you get the games in, and we'll touch base again next week, see how everything went.
Thank you.
Thank you. And thank you for joining us on the Grand Valley Sports Network. I'm DJ Foster. We'll talk to you again next week.